how to calibrate your cat payload scales. What you'll need to do as part of the 250 hours try before you buy on your machine. Now, I've already turned on my cat trial, my cat payload trial. What we need to do now is calibrate the scales before use. So as we come in here into our information, we're gonna go to our service. And inside our service, we're going to select service mode. Reach out to your Caterpillar dealer as your partner, and they can help you with the service passcode or come out and help you with this calibration. Now, I'm going to go ahead and enter my service passcode. I'm going to hit OK. And then what I'm going to have the ability to do is calibrations. So as I choose my calibrations, we're going to go through them in turn, starting with the empty bucket. So as I choose this, it's going to give me coaching all the way through. So I'll invite you to read down through, but it is important that you have access to material. It is important that you have the target bucket on the machine that you're going to calibrate it with. So as I choose OK here, yes, let's go ahead and begin the calibration. Empty bucket weight, so setup conditions. If your machine is equipped with ride control, set it to auto, which we've done, or off position, and make sure that the bucket is empty, which I have also done. So let's move on to the next step. Exercise the machine to warm them up above 104 degrees Fahrenheit. So you can see I'm currently at 100 degrees. So what I now need to do is I need to cycle my implements. So I find the best way to do that is kind of do a mock dig cycle. A combination of rack and dump, a combination of lift. Once you get the hydraulics to a point where they're reasonably warm, you can also use your auxiliary flow function. And so you can see as I'm deadheading my hydraulics in this example, now I'm going to reverse that cycle. It's going to also help me build some individual temperature. Now you can see I'm already above my target at 118. My coaching is go a little bit above, because if it's a cool day, you want the machine to stay warm all the way through the calibration procedure to give you the absolute most accurate calibration. So I'm at 122 now. I think I'm in a good spot. So I'm going to take the coaching, slowly place the bucket in the low position, set engine to high. I'm going to do that and I'm going to follow the directions. I'm going to raise the lift lever. So I'm going all the way to the top, and now that I've gotten there, the next coaching, go ahead and lower, go all the way to the bottom. I'm going to do that now as well. Now I'm all the way at the bottom, release the levers and hit the next button. Now we're going to move it to the full lift position again. So I've pulled all the way through the detent. Full, and they do mean full lift position. And you can see the linkage is lifting a slightly slower state than traditional full. Now I'm all the way to the top and it's giving me coaching. I need to go all the way back down. Again, through the detent, truly full command on the lower position. And I can see the linkage coming back down, arguably a little bit slower than normal, but it's going through its calibration procedure. Now back into the full lift. Again, full lift all the way through the detent. A nice, low, steady lift going on out there on the front end. And now saying go to our full lower position. So again, back into the low position. On its way down it goes. Release the levers and click the next button. So now let's go into next. Move the levers into the full raise position and hold. So again, back into the full raise position. A little bit quicker this time. On up it goes. All the way to max. Now into the lower position. So all the way forward, back into the lower. Back into the full lift position, second time here. Again, a little bit quicker on this series of cycles. And finally, again into the full lower position. And down it goes. and that calibration was successful, so we're going to choose OK. Now with the empty bucket weight calibration complete, let's move on to full bucket weight. So I'm going to choose my full bucket weight, and it's again telling me I need access to materials. It's giving me some coaching along the way, and OK. And we're going to hit OK to begin the process. So setup conditions, we need to have, if equipped, ride control set to auto, which we did, or off, and make sure the bucket contains the calibrated weight. So what we're going to do right now, everybody, is we are going to go ahead and fully load the bucket. So I've got access to sand out here in front. I'm going to plunge in. I'm going to lift. I'm going to get a nice full bucket full of sand. And I'm going to back away. Now I'm just going to shake a little bit of this off so we get a nice stable load. And let me back away and give myself good access to do the calibration procedure. So now that I've got a full bucket, I'm going to hit my next position. Set engine speed to high idle. I'm going to do that now, full RPM. Release the levers, then click next button. So let's hit the next button. And I'm going to get some coaching, move the lever into the full raise position and hold. So again, all the way through that max lift detent, all the way to the back. And I can tell it's doing a nice, steady, slow lift out there as expected. Now that I'm in the max, it's telling me to do the same thing, but this time lower. So back into a lower position, loaded bucket calibration here. All the way down, full raise position is the next coaching. Back up a second time here. Up through the lift range it goes. Now that I'm at top, it's gonna say full lower position. So a second time, back into the full lower position. Slightly slower linkage velocity, lower lift on this first series of calibration procedures. And now I'm at full lower, back into the full raise position, and I'm going to hold it. I'm at full raise, it's telling me to go to full lower. And then again, back into full raise position. Into the full lower position. Into the full raise position. Into the full lower position. We're just taking the coaching that's just coming to us in the on-screen calibration procedure. Into full lower, again coaching back into full raise. Into full lower again. Right now it's letting us move on to the next, and as we click next, now we're going to again pull it into the full raise. Linkage is moving a little bit quicker this time on this next series of calibration steps. Full raise, now it's suggesting full lower, and all the way through those detents, truly full max stroke on your joystick. Hold it until you get the next coaching. Back to full raise. quicker cycle on this series. And then the full lower. Calibration weight done. Calibration successful. We're going to choose OK there. And then calibration weight, our last step. The estimated cal weight is 4.73 tons. So enter calibration weight. We're going to accept the estimate for 0.73 and OK. We have just successfully calibrated CAT payload, the demo mode, try before you buy, on the next gen small loader. Now, for the best accuracy, of course, now that we've accepted the estimated way, we'd want to load a truck, check that on a ground scale and compare it to the scales, and then make any adjustments needed. But 250 hours of trial, CAT payload, try before you buy, through the calibration of the display, we can now put this to work to see if it adds value in your business, and then you can turn it on, of course, as a lifetime subscription. Standard on the next gen small loaders. Try before you buy, 250 hours of CAT payload.